Aladdin Creations.
Hello guys, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindur. Today in this short video I am going to discuss one of the most important clinical biochemistry topic, manual blood glucose measurement tests. What is the principle behind manual blood glucose measurement tests? How to perform this laboratory tests? And what are the limitations associated with laboratory tests? We will discuss in this short video. Glucose is the primary and major source of energy in the human body. It is derived from breakdown of carbohydrate in the diet and in the body's stored glycogen. Insulin secretion by islet cells in the pancreas of human body facilitates glucose entry into cells. A deficiency of insulin or a decrease of its effectiveness increases blood glucose level. Mainly, elevated serum glucose concentration is found in diabetes mellitus. Therefore, there are various methods to determine blood glucose level to maintain the glucose level in blood within the acceptable range. Principle: the glucose oxidase enzymatic method is used commonly for determination of blood glucose level. Glucose in the serum is oxidized by enzyme glucose oxidase to gluconic acid with liberation of hydrogen peroxide. The hydrogen peroxide is converted to water and molecule oxygen by the enzyme peroxidase. In the presence of oxygen acceptor or 4-aminopinosone together with pinol, a pink color coenamine is formed, which is measured. The intensity of pink color formed is proportional to the glucose concentration in serum. Specimen: serum must be separated from the red cells promptly to prevent glycolysis. The addition of sodium fluoride or potassium oxalate as an inhibitor of glycolysis and anticoagulant to blood sample. Requirements: glucose reagent, demineralized water, glucose standard, test tubes, graduated pipettes, micropipettes, spectrophotometer. Procedure: test tubes are labeled as blank, standard and test. Glucose reagent and glucose standard are warmed to room temperature before use. Then 3 ml glucose reagent is pipetted into all 3 tubes. Microliter demineralized water is pipetted into blank. 30 microliter glucose standard is pipetting into standard tube and 30 microliter sample is pipetted into test. All 3 tubes are mixed well and incubated at 37 Celsius for 10 minutes or at room temperature for 20 minutes. All tubes are shaken 2 or 3 times during the period to ensure adequate action. Absorbance is read at 510 nanometer against reagent blank within 15 minutes using spectrophotometer. the test is performed in triplicate to generate accurate results. The results are calculated using standard calculation. Glucose concentration equal to absorbance of test divided from absorbance of standard, and it is multiplied by concentration of standard. Difference range. Glucose level in serum in fasting should be less than 100 mg per deciliter. Limitation. Stability of reagent is protected if contaminations are prevented during use, and reagent must store tightly closed and protected from light after use. As this is an enzymatic reaction, the factors that control enzymatic reactions should be kept under control, such as pH, temperature, the period of incubation. High serum bilirubin level may interfere with glucose value of the assay. Pivoting errors may interfere with color development of the reaction. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and gained some knowledge about this manual blood glucose measurement test. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.